Okay, Claudia.
So as you know, you've got 10 minutes to present. After your presentation, you have a seat and you receive questions from the commission. There's pen and paper there because you need to make notes.
Okay.
You can start.
So, good afternoon. As you can see, I'm going to present the relation between incident planning and oral performance efficiency. The content of this slide. The establishment was the school, Colegio Merta, located in Puente Alto. It was a 7th grade with 30 students, 29 at the beginning, and then another student came in the middle of the semester. The average age of the students was 13 years old. Research question. Is there a relation between incidence of learning and the degree of proficiency in oral performance from students in 7th grade inside a Chilean classroom? So, the background. According to the Ministry of Education, MINEDUC, listening comprehension is vital in language learning, as through it, students will receive comprehensible input needed then to interact inside the classroom. This is probably based in the input hypothesis of exposed by Krashen. That explains that the more input that we receive, the more we will develop the acquired knowledge. Together with this, in my research, I talked a lot about the attitude that students have. So one of the references that I used was from Batia and Ricci, that they explained that the positive attitudes in regards to English language and language learning typically have a repercussion, or they have an effect on the degree of performance in the target language. And how is this positive attitude measured? So together with that, in 1985, Gardner exposed that there were two types of attitudes or motivations. Those are instrumental and integrative. And integrative is the one that I'm focusing on this study, since it relates a little bit more to how students feel to the culture and how they enjoy the different things that relate to entertainment and habits and all of those things that are daily. The research objective. The objective of this study was to determine whether those students that are more exposed to the English language have a noticeable different performance than those who are not exposed to it. And to get to find this relationship, I needed to use the a qualitative type of research using the post-positivist paradigm, because this would be a correlational study, since one of the variables is not directly affected by the other. It's just a possibility. So the main tool of analysis that I used was the Pearson's correlation coefficient, since it was really the simplest correlation coefficient that I can use. The main concepts. For the main concepts, I define incidental learning as how many hours each student is exposed to different sources of the language, since I cannot really measure incidental learning itself, because I would have to be with them the entire day. I used a survey asking different questions in regards to how much time do they spend in social media using English, websites, watching movies, series, and different other sources. For oral performance, literally oral performance is what I used. In the practicum, we had a project in which the students had to, in groups, present a poster in which all of them had to talk about different green issues. So that's what I used for the performance part. The data collection materials. For the incidental learning, I used the survey, as I explained before, in the mother tongue, so they wouldn't be confused. And here I found the first issue that's related to validity. And that is that I didn't consider all of the aspects. For example, I considered social media, websites, movies, series, TV programs, radio programs, books, and music, but didn't cover aspects that I believe to be really important in this age, that is video games, in which they are really likely to be exposed to those sources of language. And actually, one of the ones that I was most exposed to. For the oral performance, we worked together with my tutor in the practicum, but we didn't really develop a new rubric. We adapted one that was used in a previous oral presentation that they had, that was in pairs. So it had to be a little bit adapted, and the contents were taken out because those would have tampered with how their grades were, and wouldn't have shown only their oral performance. So I decided to take out all of those aspects and leave it just the pronunciation, fluency, and word choice, since I thought that those were the three main aspects that could have been more affected by being exposed to the language. The data. So, after I took the results of the survey, I could observe that one of the most maybe shocking things was that two of the students actually answered with 0 points, that they aren't really exposed to the language whatsoever throughout the entire week. It was surprising in a way, because one of those two students, which I didn't include the names of, actually did a really good job in the presentation. So, well, as you can see, the maximum points were 72, if I'm correct. Yes, 72 points. Those were, as I showed you before, 8 questions in which students had to answer from 0 to 9. 0 representing 0 hours exposed to that source, and 9 representing 9 or more. The highest score, was 63 points. Yeah, there's something that I left out, I think. But that's in regards to the oral performance, in which, I can go back to this, okay. So it's 3 aspects in which the maximum is 7 points, so it's a total of 21 points. The maximum reached by 2 students was 20 points, really high. Also, in this oral presentation, 78% of the students passed the minimum for approval, which was 13 points. So 78% of the students got 13 points or more. After analyzing the data, we can observe now that there is a positive slope in the data, but it is quite messy in a way. It's not really showing much of it. But indeed, there is a positive slope which represents a positive correlation. This positive correlation has a coefficient 0.3, which is a weak correlation, but indeed a positive one. And then after that, I calculated the p-value to measure how these results were statistically if they were statistically relevant. So then I used an alpha of 0.05 and I got a p-value of 0.1 again, and the number was above 0.1, so this shows that even though there is a positive correlation, it is not statistically relevant. The conclusions. Well, first of all, I decided to use or go to this area of research since I saw that many of the students that I had in this classroom were really interested in other cultures, such as the Japanese culture and Korean culture. And I thought, relating it to my own experience that I learned from being exposed to the language when I was little, from video games, movies, and I wanted to learn how these kids really learned if they were connected to the English culture, but to others. And I realized that there might be a connection, and although it is not statistically relevant in this research, I think that this research could be developed more with a bigger group and maybe with more time, because I don't think that only one performance can represent a student's competence or what they have learned throughout that entire year. Also, some of the issues that I had with developing the data was that although there were 30 students, I could use the data of only 27 because some of them were not able to answer the survey because they were not there. Some others were not present in the day of the presentation. So I decided to, instead of using red marks because of them not being there, to take out all of those elements that would maybe change the outcome of the analysis to make it a little more transparent. Also, going to the metacognitive part of the conclusions, I can say that although I could observe that the correlation, the positive correlation that I found, is not statistically relevant, I can still see how the way in which students relate to the culture might be really important because of the attitude that some students have of being so reluctant to the use of another language might be affected by it. If some students see the English culture, either American culture, Irish culture, or whichever other country that speaks the language, as too far away from them, they are not going to be interested in learning the language because they are not going to see it as something that they are going to use. So, personally, I would love to continue this research, adding more to it, and continue observing the different aspects that there may be, considering how the exposure of the language can affect in how a student performs orally. Going more through my process of the research itself, I could learn that positive studies can be a little bit tricky sometimes, and even though you can get to have the data that shows that there might be something or there might not be something there, that data may not always be something that represents what you believe to be true. And because I always thought that being exposed to the language had a big, huge impact on how we would perform, because that was my own experience. So it was eye-opening finding these results that were not really relevant to the community. Furthermore, I think that throughout the entire practicum, I had a great time doing the classes. And I think that the fact that I used data that was so specific, I could use more of my time not necessarily taking field notes or any of that data, and could focus more on enjoying performing as a teacher, and that's something that I appreciate. I'm out of words to explain, because that was one of the most enjoyable things that I had throughout the entire semester. And well, that is my presentation. Those are the references that I used in my entire research. And thank you.
Thank you.